Today I'm going to the country of Italy. To this place here, to be exact, I believe it is pronounced Civitavecchia. And it's the main port for the city of Rome. And it was from here that a ship, a cruise liner by the name of the Costa Concordia, left on January 13th, 2012. They headed north, and they didn't get very far before they had a major accident and things went seriously wrong. Now, this particular image of Google Earth still has, if you look in close, you can still see basically the sunken ship right here along the island of Giglio. And this was a time when they had big boats and big machines out there working on getting it upright and pulling it back to a port where they were going to repair it. But eventually, they ended up completely scrapping it because there was way too much damage. Now, what happened was this. As they were heading north, the captain decided that he would bring the ship close into the island of Giglio, right in here, because the head waiter's family lived on this island. So the captain decided to bring it in close so that the head waiter could wave to his family. Now, the head waiter's sister, shortly before the accident, posted on Facebook, "In a short period of time, the Concordia will pass very close. A big greeting to my brother who finally gets to have a holiday on landing in Savona." And I'm pretty sure that, I mean, I'm not positive, but I'm assuming that the family members lived somewhere in here and the ship was going to come by and they were going to wave to each other and then the ship was going to head up north to continue on its 7-night cruise. But we all know things went terribly wrong because the Concordia struck a rock underwater, and I believe that this was or is the rock that the Concordia struck. Now, once it struck this rock, on the left rear portion of the ship, or the port rear portion, it ripped a 50-meter gash, or a gash that was 160 feet long. As a result, water came pouring into the engine compartment and flooded all the engines. The engines quit working. In addition to that, it short-circuited all the electrical. And as a result, the ship kind of came around and everything quit. I'm assuming it was somewhere up here where everything quit running. And once it quit running, the wind blew the ship back and turned the front of it around. Now keep in mind, this is the front and this is the back. The front was heading north and the wind kind of blew it all the way around and slammed it into the island where you can see right here. Now at the time of the accident, there were 3,206 passengers and 1,023 crew members. Out of all of these people, 32 people died, and the last body was discovered November 3rd, 2014, after they had the ship uprighted, and I'm not sure if it was in a dry dock when they found that body or if it was in a harbor. But it was almost 2 years later that they found the last body of the 32 people that were killed during this accident. The final scrapping of the ship was completed on July 7th, 2017. So from the time it crashed on January 13th to the time they completed scrapping it was 5.5 years. And it also cost a total of $2 billion to get the ship upright, float it back to a port, and eventually to completely scrap it. They were thinking about restoring it, but there was too much damage and too much deep structural damage that it was beyond repair. So there you have it, a brief description of the Costa Concordia's accident that occurred on January 13th, 2012, right here from Google Earth.